Superstar video blogger Logan Paul is facing a major backlash after posting a video on YouTube of what appears to show a body hanging from a tree. It's in a Japanese forest known for suicides. Social media users were quick to slam the video, which Paul has since removed. On Monday, he apologized, saying he hoped to raise awareness about suicide, but that did little to stop the anger. Now, without showing the graphic part, here's some of that video.
Obviously, and now experiencing it real life and firsthand, suicide is not a joke. Depression and mental illnesses are not a joke.
I don't feel very good.
Yeah, I don't feel good.
Well, you never stand next to a dead guy?
No.
Stop.
I just can't believe
God damn it.
Like, we joke about seeing things in here, and like,
it was gonna be a joke.
Yeah,
this was all gonna be a joke. Why did it become so real?
It was all gonna be a joke. That part got him in trouble. Paul apologized again on Tuesday. Psychoanalyst and author Bethany Marshall is joining us now to talk more about this. Let's first talk about what kind of psychological impact can it have on someone who is depressed, who has had suicidal thoughts, who is going through a mental illness, who sees something like this,
right,
on a site that is extremely popular with young people.
So popular, it has 15 million viewers. The psychological impact is profound and overwhelming. In fact, we know that with suicide, there's actually a social contagion aspect. Let's keep in mind, Sarah, that children ages 10 to 14, suicide is the third leading cause of death for that age group. And then for young people ages 15 through 34, it's the second leading cause of death. And in terms of social contagion, which is something that we see on social media sites, somebody who is already vulnerable, depressed, has some kind of a psychiatric illness, is thinking about suicide already, will be more likely to attempt suicide after viewing or hearing about suicide. And there's very robust research that backs this up.
Wow, when you talk about the numbers too, it puts it into perspective. I think the number of suicides in the United States has risen to its highest level in 30 years.
It's increased about 25% over the last year.
What advice do you have for parents whose children may have seen this, or whose children, a lot of whom are YouTube watchers, they idolize the men and women on YouTube who have so many viewers. What advice do you give to parents when something like this happens? How do you talk to your kids about it?
Well, don't attack Logan Paul, because it's only going to entrench their attachment to him. Mm-hmm. I think that you need to acquaint yourself with your child's cyber world just as well acquainted as you are with the playground, their teachers, their friends, the people they spend the night with. Monitor how much time they spend online. If there is a computer in the house that's connected to the internet, make sure it's in a public area, that it's facing outwards so that you can monitor it all time. Be your child's best friend. Use all the parental filtering devices, and let your child know that you are going to be checking in on their chats. You're going to be looking at that browsing history, and that they can process anything they see, and that they're never supposed to give out private information online.
Can Logan Paul sort of undo the damage in some way? Is there something that he could do with 15 million viewers to try and help this situation and help people who have had these thoughts? Because the numbers show someone watching most likely has had suicidal thoughts.
Absolutely. Well, when you see his response, he sees the dead body, and then he says something like, oh my God, there's a dead body, and then he laughs. And there's all this what we call inappropriate affect. It's when you have one feeling and then you pair it with a response that doesn't even match up with the feeling. And I think that what he needs to instruct his young viewers to do is to talk to their parents, their priest, their minister, their teacher, their counselor, so that they begin a dialogue at home. He's become very self-referential by saying, oh, I've never made a mistake like this before. Mm. Oh, I didn't realize how influential I was. Mm. Logan Paul has to stop referring to himself. He needs to talk to his little viewers and tell them to talk to their parents so they can really get the appropriate support.
You talked about, you know, his reaction, and he said, oh, I was in shock. And I think the very first response that he wrote out, a lot of people were upset by it, and then he came out and he did another one. Do you think this is a case of someone who got caught and has never, he said, faced this kind of negativity, and suddenly you have to do something because you don't want to lose that viewership as well?
Well, he's faced negativity, but not that he's known about. He's only 22 years old. Yeah. I mean, look at all the training you've been through to have this position, to be in the anchor's chair. You have journalistic standards. You're well aware of the impact on the viewers. This is kind of like a psychic trying to do therapy. You know, somebody who wades into waters where they're really unprepared, they're uneducated, there's no guidelines, there's no state licensure for this. So he has a very, very strong bully pulpit, and he has to be aware of that.
Yeah, he's an influencer, is I think what they call YouTubers and other people on social media that have such a large following. Maybe one of the things he can do is bring you on or bring someone on to give people some real help, professionals. Right. Thank you so much. I appreciate you coming on.